Got a little break in the weather. Patrick came down from Bishop to do things today.
Do things.
Yeah.
We're doing some things today.
We're gonna show him all the trails at Holda, and then we're gonna go test some trials bikes. Jeff Aaron's coming today, Donnie. Pat's gonna show him what's up.
I'll show him a few things.
Skills
yeah.
time.
Yeah.
I think we'll all learn something.
Nando.
What's up?
Are you sending it today?
No, I'm taking it easy today.
Come on.
You weren't a minute ago.
Pinball is your forte. The first turn.
Go fast.
So we had a pretty badass morning. Pat Foster drove down from Bishop, and we rode Holda Crooks. Rode e-bikes so that we could do all six laps. Super fun. Always fun to show Pat new places down here to ride. Now you can see the back of the truck. Got a trials bike back there. So the guys at Gas gave us a TXT 300 to ride. And Jeff Aaron, 10-time national champion, is coming out to meet us. We're riding in a place called Santa Rosa Mayan, which is actually, I think it's like 15 minutes from my house up in the hills. So should be fun. Trials is something I haven't done in a long time. I kind of farted around with one a couple years ago because my nephew just started riding motor trials and he's pretty badass. I thought I'd come off the couch and dust him, but he kicked my ass. So anyway, now that Gas is owned by KTM Group, I think we might be able to keep this bike for a while, so it'll rejuvenate my trials career. anyway, should be fun. Sleeping bag pad from Boy Scouts.
For Boy Scouts?
Yeah.
I heard they wouldn't let you back in. let's see here. Got on the shit. Let's see here.
Get to find them.
Yeah.
Jess likes to give you a lot of shit, dude.
Yeah, yeah. Mind you this.
Dude, he talks so much shit to me. Hey, when I saw him in California, he said, hey, buddy, you know, get the hell away from me. The COVID came from your people.
Am I wrong? I'm just kidding.
Am I wrong?
Am I wrong?
Is this a triumphant return to action?
Well, I went on a secret one the other day by myself yesterday.
Did you?
Went to I did 13 and a half miles yesterday.
On the road or the mountain bike?
On this dog.
Oh shit, where'd you go? To the KTM
it's
trail?
It's a secret trail. I found one by our house, not KTM Cross, something else. But we gotta get it back because I had a bad experience.
Bad initial experience. You know,
I'm glad it was a last minute call. So let's go, let's go.
Have you ridden here yet? No. Yeah, you have, right?
No.
Oh, no.
Hey, race out, I gotta come. This will get, this will bring
this
everything back.
This place is
back.
Fun. This place is fun. Back. Here we go. No, no, it's good. So Will, is this, is this the first time Enzo's service suspension for a social media influencer?
Yes, it is.
It is.
It is.
So, where is the buttery
right
component?
Here.
Oh, right here. Oh, he even got the new dials. So what do you think of the coatings by Jason Butchke at SGB Racing?
They look good.
Huh? Looks good?
Yep.
Alright.
Here's your rotors and stuff.
Rotors.
The ones that were on it?
Yeah. Dang, dude. I don't know why anyone would run a stock hub and not Cerakote it.
It definitely gives it a custom look, that's for sure.
It does.
And it's durable finish, so yeah. Yeah, they came out really good.
So they can Cerakote other things besides hubs, right? Like
for sure.
Engine cases and...
People do it all the time.
Brake master cylinders and all that,
Yeah, brake calipers, engine cases.
Do you send that stuff out? Like, are you a resource for other stuff too?
We don't typically do that a lot. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we'll do triple clamps if it's like a whole deal for somebody. But certainly it can be done.
Yeah.
For sure. People do it all the time.
Okay, so say Joe buys a new Honda 450. Once get his hub Cerakoted, you can bring the wheel down sans tire. You can unlace it, do this beautiful thing to it.
Yep.
How much does that cost?
So, well, there's a couple ways you can go about it. If you, typically if a guy just has stock wheels and wants that done, you could use the stock spokes, but then you have to put the stock rim on it because on the rear of a Honda is a 32 hole.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a little different. Oftentimes what people do if they're gonna upgrade their wheels, they'll put new rims on it and then we'll do new spokes and everything. And I think our packages are, I think they start at like $450, and depending on if you add Cerakote, could add a couple $100 to it. Depending on the rim you get, there's a lot of options.
Yeah, that's worth it because most stock wheels are soft.
They are.
And they get beat up. And then
for sure.
You get a wheel built by your magicians here.
Yep, that's right.
Are you going green, bud?
Dude, I'm not taking the green one this time. I got something in the works, thanks to you, but I'm not going with the green one. I do like this bike, though, but everyone rides them, so I don't know. And your bars are about to come off, so I don't really like that either.
Hey, show me your fancy shit.
Come over here. Come take a look.
Yeah, because...
I've never had anything really that cool or factory in my life. This is by far the coolest thing I've ever had. Shout out to Don and Enzo for coming through with this.
And
SGB.
SGB Racing.
With the coatings. SGB Racing. Look at that. Black lugs. Gold on the bottom. White up top. And this is a secret. I didn't even know this was happening. Gold shock shaft.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm all about looks, not about speed. So I'm pretty stoked on this stuff.
They, I asked them if they'd ever sponsor an influencer before.
What'd they say?
They said, no, you're the first.
I'm the first influencer?
Hey, Yoshi over there is excited, dude.
Dude, I'm glad.
Do you know who Yoshi is?
Yeah, I worked with him when he was doing with Hill. So it'd be cool to actually test because I've never tested before.
Uh-huh.
So maybe get a nice setting and maybe I'll line up. You never know. Influencer races? No He's promises.
All. He's all. Oh, Donnie. That's not for battery?
Yoshi's so funny.
Yeah.
That dude's all time.
He is pumped. Yeah.
I'm stoked on this stuff.
Can't wait to see the bike.
Bike coming soon.
Bike, she with the pink-haired vixen.
I think I got a better chick than that.
Oh, okay. All right. Short timer here. Comes and rides. One moto early in the day. Packs it up. Be like some sort of credit card scam. Got some camera. He's gonna go try to return it and get the cash.
Hey, Buttery told me to keep it, but I'm condemning that.
So what camera did you supposedly buy?
Oh, it's under the seat. It's so ugly, I brought it with me.
What kind of camera?
A 7D Mark II.
Why'd you buy that when you just bought the other camera?
Because I thought it would be better. Listening to this guy.
Dallas?
Hey, but they gave it to me with no battery, so I'm sending it back.
It came with no battery.
No battery. And they looked at me like I took it. So I called the manager and he was like, all right, come on out and stay in your car. I'm like, because then you can't go in the store.
Well, I wouldn't let you in the store looking like that. Hey, come over here. Let me.
What's that? Look how clean he looks.
Let me look at the naps here.
Oh, yeah, man. Hey, actually, this stuff is so soft. It's like.
It looked like steel wool.
No, man. That's why they call me Scrub Daddy. I just.
You ever find any tree bark or branches in there?
No. Not yet.
Not born.
Be rabbit.
I'm not.
How old are you now?
14.
You look like you aged 3 years when you cut your hair.
It's little B rabbit.
When you shaved your head,
yeah.
I'm not the first person to call him B-Rabbit, am I?
No, when we were doing it, we were bleaching his hair. I said, you look like B-Rabbit.
Oh, yeah.
And then people were calling me Slim Shady.
You need to start wearing giant white t-shirts. Yeah?
White t-shirts and baggy pants.
Yeah. So what do you think? How long till you're the fastest keeper in the household?
Oh, here probably we go. Another year, probably.
Dude, there's no...
I think so.
Dude, he just doesn't have the aggression I have now.
Yeah.
Like, he's getting old.
I mean, we all saw the aggression he had at Fox Raceway, right?
Yep. I mean,
you know, so.
Look, it's going to be at least 14 now. I'm going to say by 18. So maybe then. I'm
next
too competitive.
Year. I'm saying before next 18.
Year. Really?
Yeah.
Next year.
Dude, look how fast he got when he got on big bikes. He's good.
But I'll just step up my game.
You'll step it up?
Well.
You'll dig into the bag of knowledge? At what age will you stop fucking with him when he's sleeping?
When he moves out. Hey, it never gets old. It never gets old. When the cheese gets in his mouth and he doesn't know it, I don't care. It's funny.
Hey, it's nice to see that at 14, you're not too cool to sit on your dad's lap.
No, you know what? I brought him up. He says I love you before he goes to bed. This is debatable, but I still give him a kiss. I mean, that's just how we do it.
Yeah.
And if you're ever too cool for that, I would have bust you up.
Hey, I seen Anton kiss his dad on the mouth in the press box.
I like Anton. That's why. He's cool.
Yeah.
But don't ever be too cool, B-Rabbit.
Quick jump.
Look at that. Never spill to the top every time. We did our motos today. Now we gotta go get our Instagram clips.
Damn. He's getting better.
I know, he's getting good.
Can he keep up now?
He's pretty damn fast. He's right around. I'll push it just a little bit harder just to get that edge on him. Yeah, I'm getting old. I'm about to pass the torch. I think 21 will be his year. This is my last year kind of doing my deal.
So LD, a rare sighting of little Donnie Emler at a motocross track.
Well, it's a rare sighting for everyone because they're finally back open again here in California, which is insane. We're out here riding, felt amazing to get out, sweat out some of this California sunshine. And what we were doing, we were riding it out, dude.
Yeah. So when quarantine happened, all that nonsense, and people are freaking out and like staying in their house with a mask on and everything, you guys went against the grain and came out with the Ride It Out campaign, right? Like, oh, let's.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the great thing about motorcycles is you can always find a place to ride. You know, if they tell you that you can't keep this motocross track open, you know what? We're gonna go up to the desert. We're gonna go to the high desert, we're gonna go hit the trails, and you know, you still need to get out and have life, man. So yeah. we're riding it out together with you guys, and hopefully you guys are finding a place to go ride your dirt bikes too.
Yeah. So tell me about the drop.
The drop, it's cranking, man. We're having so much fun with the drop. This month we teamed up with Stasic. You guys don't know what it is. It's a subscription service. You get an FMF t-shirt every month, but the cool thing is it'll never go on sale anywhere, so it's only for the members only. Mm-hmm. Every month we team up with a new artist. I think we're gonna do one with Swapmoto Live here soon. We're gonna turn Don loose on the graphic design, so if you guys haven't heard about it, go check it out, fmfracing.com, drop. You can always get cool stuff in your box. This month you might want a Stasic e-drive bike for the kids. You never know.
That's like, oh, is it empty in here? What are you guys doing?
We're cleaning out.
Huh?
Cleaning house.
Cleaning house on the 20 bikes?
Yeah, let's go.
January 21? So I got to convert these back to exact.
Exact, yeah.
So Meatball said they were too stiff for him.
Yeah, too stiff for me.
Come on, dude.
They were like,
you're way faster
forks
than me. No.
I like them soft.
I rode those off road.
Really?
Yeah, good though. Dude, the smaller the tire, the harder it is.
I'm gonna be here all day doing this.
What size is that, a 10?
Yeah.
10 inch?
Yeah, 10 inch.
Come on, we're doing a tech tip video.
Yeah. All right. You're asking the wrong person for a tech tip on this one. I need Jay Clark to come put a Dunlop on this thing.
Oh yeah, the tube in it already.
Yeah. I feel like the tube's gonna be,
dude, that sprocket's the same size as the wheel. It's gonna get you.
Oh, I'm gonna bloody knuckles after the end of this.
Aren't you supposed to do it the other side?
Oh, this side?
Yeah, so you're not working with the sprocket.
That's sharp too.
Yeah, still.
I'm gonna have to give up.
They just order a new part number with the tire on it,
yeah,
right?
Exactly.
So, Brocia,
yeah.
Has anyone given you crap about your kit? Like competing in media outlets?
No.
No,
no,
not
no
yet?
No one's ever said a word.
Dude, you look racy. Hey, you look like a weapon in that thing, dude.
I told my wife, I said, I look fat. I go, look at me, I look fat in this.
Oh, no way.
And she's like, no. I said, oh, okay.
Dude,
it's good, though. The kid's nice.
Yeah. Muto XC. Dudes are from Tijuana.
Uh-huh.
That run that company.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I think it's a great kit. I like how the sleeves are so stretchy, because
yeah.
A lot of times the uncomfortable thing about a road kit is how tight the sleeves
are.
Right. I don't know, it's good.
Yeah, it's really good.
Hey, people were freaking on your teal bike too.
Yeah, I know, I love it.
Huh?
Yeah, I love that bike.
Yeah. So this thing just got offered up to us. Should we put A-Ray on this? Make a video? Two-stroke video? Look at this poser. At least he washed it.
Donald!
So did?
Hi!
Hi, Susie. Whoa, what is that?
That's Bud. Bud the shop pig.
Dude, why is he so little?
He's only like 2 months old. I think 2 months. He's cool as hell. He just creeps around. He's scared of Japanese dudes still.
He thinks they're gonna eat him, right?
Yeah, with chopsticks. What up,
hey,
Don?
Hey, so place has come along.
It is.
a lot of these helmets are getting ready to come off the wall too.
Why? What are you gonna do?
We're building repaint the second the level in two offices up here.
Oh shit. Yeah. Business is good.
Business is booming, dog.
Nice.
Yeah, it's gonna be good. Getting ready to do the two offices.
Oh yeah, the racks are new.
I got
you got the bikes on.
Yeah, I got the bikes on. I just we just bought more racks too. Getting ready. I gotta get them all painted before I put them up.
What happened to that rack?
That was two Honda 110s.
Oh, that's great. That looks good.
Just getting there. All that shit was in my closet in my house.
Dude, your pigs run away.
Fix dipping.
Skinny he was. And are those true religion?
Hey.
Are those true religion jeans in that poster? Huh?
I was waiting for something like that.
Are they?
Probably.
There's some jewels on the pockets.
I never wore the bedazzled ones, but those are for sure like true. There's some designer jeans. You can just tell the way they're ripped.
Yeah, dude, look at that.
That was from like...
Those are $200 jeans, bro.
That was definitely from like 06 or 07 when I started making money.
Mm. I bet Susie knows.
What's that?
I bet Susie knows.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that thing.
He's sweet. He just tries to run
He's
out.
He's going
to
get huge, huh?
No. He'll be as big as my Frenchie.
Why you got this one by the trash can, dude?
Transworld?
Yeah.
Because Transworld is trash. I'm Swapmoto only, dog.
Yeah, Transworld is trash.
You always have my back over there, though.
It's old shit.
It's old shit. We're on the new shit, 2020.
Dude, look at this.
Old. Remember an old Krusty Mag back in the day?
Did you have the old grill in that picture?
Nah, I have my legit teeth then. Yeah? Look at the watch. Come on, you know I was spending money back then.
That watch almost cost as much as those jeans over there.
And that watch is probably as much as my truck.
All right, so... 10 grand, 100,000 yen.
A million yen.
A million yen.
Which is only 10 grand US. Yeah.
30 grand. Do you remember what you spent any of those like checks on? Like, did you say, I won this thing, I'm gonna go buy out?
Oh, I remember if I won 30 grand, I spent like 32 grand. I don't remember, no. One of those years, I bought like, I think I bought like 4 or 5 BMWs that year. It was when the first year of the 7 Series came out.
Uh-huh.
I bought a white one, or no, I bought a silver one, a used one,
uh-huh,
with gray interior. Then I seen this white one come out with cream interior, so I bought a brand new one of those. And then I bought a black one because I wanted the all black 7 Series. And then the convertible came out that year, and that's when I had my beach house at Hermosa, so I bought my wife.
Wait, so you kept all four at the same time, or you just replaced?
I kept them all. Come on, dude. When you go from being dead broke to making a shitload of money, you spend it.
Oh, that's that. Hey, the Rolling Stone up there.
Uh-huh.
What's going on? You got your helmet on your dick?
Butt naked with a gas can on my dick.
Oh, well, you're holding it.
Yeah. That was for Rolling Stone. They're like, you want to do this photo? I'm like, sure. And the show, they're like, all right, we need you butt naked. We're going to oil you. Actually, I had like a man thong on. It was just like nude color. That was forever ago. That was from that gnarly photographer, David LaChapelle.
Ah. Dude, you remember that chicken one with Troy Lee, and he had his helmet on his dick, but he had to get hard to hold the helmet up?
No. Did he have to have a Viagra?
Huh? I don't know.
That's a pretty good one. I might have to do that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dude, all that shit was just literally in my closet.
Dude, the kits with the photos, that's... Yep. Is that Smith guy did these?
Yeah, Smithline.
Yeah.
I've had those forever.
Yeah, I remember those in the house.
This one was from 09, that one was from 2010 to 2011 maybe? No, 2010, and then 2009. The dates on them up there, I didn't see that. I have so much more shit that I need framed, I've just been too lazy to do it.
Hey, that one, you look like, you and Villapoto look the same.
That's when Thor's gear was dope. Yeah. Me, Villapoto, Chad Reed. Yeah, like all those helmets.
Yeah, I like that kit. That kit was my favorite kit.
That year, every single set of gear I had matching helmet, and they're on the wall. All my Thor helmets matched whatever gear I wore that year. That was sick.
Hey, Potter doesn't look too pumped in the background.
He's definitely not pumped. He should have been, I think. Yeah, I got a bronze. He's holding a gold.
Really? No, you don't look too happy.
That's just Potter.
E-bike adventures with Garth.
Let's do this.
So what is this trail call that we're doing?
So we're going to do Rim Nordic and Exploration today since we have e-bikes. So we're going to go up Keller Peak. We're going to ride across almost to Snow Valley and down over to Rim Nordic. We're going to do a lap there, do this really fun downhill called Black Bear. And we're going to come back across, ride back over to catch the trail back up, ride at the top of the trail again since we have e-bikes. And then we're going to bomb down that 4.5 mile trail too and get down here, and should be about close to 20 miles when it's all said and done.
Nice. Best thing about the Levo? Full battery.
What kind of smack are you talking?
I'm talking about how good this bike looks. I can't get over it, man.
You never seen it that up close, huh? It's usually pulling away.
It ain't never this clean.
Oh, come on.
Today it's extra clean.
I washed it.
With the fresh meat too?
I see you just standing around.
I'm waiting on you guys to motor,
oh,
man.
No, no, are you just standing around pretending to talk to people? You're trying to watch that girl change into her gear.
Where's she at?
Oh, yeah, where's she at?
Man, if you don't...
She's right there.
I ain't seen no girl where.
Oh, yeah,
her,
see?
I seen the bike.
See?
She has a nice bike. I seen that number around.
Hey, you're so busted, dude. Scrub daddy. Lust is a sin.
Hey, that's what I'm not doing.
Hey, what,
you haven't seen it around?
No. Oh, see? Now he's trying to come talk to you while you're changing.
No, I'm not even seeing it. That's all him.
He's trying to watch you change.
Yeah, that's exactly
what happened. Huh? Yeah.
That's definitely not what's happening.
See?
That's all him. See, he likes to put it on me so that way.
Hey, I saw your eyes just now.
This guy's funny.
Brian.
Get out of my seat.
Scrub daddy. Yeah, right?
You ever ride at State Fair? Have you ever rode there?
She does.
Okay. See, so don't say I ain't never saw it
before. No label.
Big clothes.
Hey,
I got good GoPro of you.
Did you get me flying out?
No.
Oh,
cause,
no. Well,
did you? You ran me off the track.
Did I?
Yeah, because when we first went on, I went in that corner and you came in and went, brah!
I know, because I didn't know if you're going or if you're not going.
Yeah, so I flew off the track, so I jumped back on and you're already down.
Oh, shit. Sorry.
Hey, you move out there.
Thank you.
Yeah, what do you think of Kauai, first time?
I think it's awesome because I like the elevation, going up and down.
Up and down, off.
Yeah, and the dirt is awesome. I like the corners. Definitely Pella or Stafford, I don't know corners like that at all.
Yeah.